So many weekend events. We touched on some just a little bit ago. And coming up after Allison's workout, we're going to see a bit of her adventure at the alpaca farm in Tryon, Georgia.
I cannot wait to see it. That is such a special place down at TMMA Farms. Mm-hmm. And so we are going to check that out in just a bit. But first, Allison's going to tell us what we need to prepare for today.
So it's another day where you want to go ahead and dress in some layers. So yes, you need that jacket this morning. It is chilly outside for areas, especially to the east of Chattanooga. Dalton, you're now down into the 30s. So 39 in Dalton and in Cleveland, Dayton as well. We're still sitting in the 40s in Chattanooga at 42 degrees. And you'll notice a little bit more warmth up to the northwest. So 49 in Altamont. As we go through the day today, though, that's when that temperatures are really going to be climbing up. So very similar to yesterday. Pleasant for your lunchtime, 66 degrees. You're going to have plentiful sunshine really for the morning and the first part of the afternoon. A few clouds will begin to roll in from the west by about 3 p.m. So we'll call it mostly sunny then, but look at that temperature, 72 degrees. That's also kickoff for the Blue Cross Bowl for South Pittsburgh playing today. So if you're heading to the football game, really comfortable temperatures for the players on the field and the fans in the stand. We'll stay comfortable through the evening as well, 65 at 6 o'clock and then partly cloudy and 58 at 9 p.m. So for Friday night plans, we got some Christmas parades tonight. Dress for temperatures generally dropping from the low 60s into the 50s, so still not too bad for the beginning of December. We're going to be closer to record high temperatures today than what is normal. Now, here's the big picture of what's ongoing. Clear skies, quiet as we're looking at the radar, nothing showing up into the southeast. This cold front is not really going to have an effect on us. It'll stay to the north of our area. Warm front slides in, helping to kind of push more of that air from the south into our region, hence those 70s for the afternoon. So let's go through the day today and then look into the weekend as well. So here's future cast about 1 o'clock this afternoon. Again, plentiful sunshine where we are. A few of those clouds will start rolling in late afternoon into the evening times, though partly cloudy skies overnight. By tomorrow, though, that's when we're going to have that greater cloud cover. So becoming mostly cloudy. As this cold front drapes across our area, it's not going to make a big impact, but we'll have a chance for a couple of little spotty sprinkles here and there. I would say still keep your plans to be outside on Saturday, even on Sunday. I've bumped it up to 20%, but it's still not going to be any kind of soaking event. So certainly you can still enjoy it. When we need to have that raincoat handy, well, that's going to be on Monday morning as this stronger cold front comes through. So temperature is still mild, getting to around 60 degrees. But once that front passes with that rainfall, really falling off from there and clearing out. So if you like the warm weather, enjoy today. Milder temperatures for the weekend in the 60s, so perfect for visiting some alpacas. And then Monday, that's when you want to have that raincoat handy and ready to go. 62 degrees for that high. Wednesday is going to be another soaking rain. In fact, Wednesday probably will have heavier rainfall, so a bit more active next week than what we experienced this week.
So I gotta ask, how was it yesterday?
It was great. I think then I pushed my luck. I was with alpacas. I was feeding them out of the hands, out of the bucket. We were in there for like 10, 15 minutes, no issues.
Yeah. Okay.
Then towards the very end, I got spit upon.
It was
full frontal.
It
wasn't like brushing the arm down at the leg. It was alpaca lifted the head up straight on
like
me.
Like cocked back, and we all saw it about to happen. And
yes.
Then...
Did you not have time to dodge it?
No, it was, I mean, it's like one of those moments. I'm looking down and then it lifts its head, then I look up and then it's just direct spit.
Right in your face.
I mean, literally she was picking like food out of my hair.
Oh, poor thing.